the cold, the hungry and the oppressed, the sick and those who mourn, the lonely and the beloved, the aged and little children, as well as those who do not yet know the love of our Lord Jesus Christ. Finally, let us remember before God all the saints, saints like Mary, the mother of our Lord, and that whole multitude which no one can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom in Jesus we are one forevermore. And now to sum up these petitions and requests, let us all join together and pray the words which Christ himself taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.
Reading from Isaiah chapter 9. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shine. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Great will be his authority, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
reading from the book of the prophet Micah, chapter 5. But you, O Bethlehem of Ephrathah, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient days. Therefore he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel, and he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sing with me again, our little town of Bethlehem.
Hear now a reading from the Gospel according to Luke chapter 1. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, O favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at the saying, and tried to discern what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. And he will be great, and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there will be no end." And Mary said to the angel, "How will this be, since I am a virgin?" And the angel answered her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore the child born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month with her who was called barren, for nothing will be impossible with God." And Mary said, "Behold, I am the servant of the Lord. Let it be to me according to your word." And the angel departed from her. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver a child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in bands of cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place in the guest room. This is the word of God.
Thanks be to God.
And in the same region, there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over the flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with great fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom he is pleased." When the angels went away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger. The word of the Lord.
Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the
star when it rose and have come to worship him. When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all of Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. In Bethlehem in Judea, they replied, for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel. Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me, so that I too may go and worship him. After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child and his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream to not go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let's sing together now, What Child Is This? Please stand for reading from the Gospel according to John, chapter 1, verses 1 through 14. Remain standing for the final hymn and image. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. Were made through him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of mortals. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. He came as a witness, to bear witness about the light, that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but came to bear witness about the light. The true light, which gives life to everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to his own, and his own people did not receive him. But to all who did receive him, who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of human will, but of God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we have seen his glory, glory as of the only Son from the Father, full of grace and truth. This is the Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our benediction was written by Dr. Calvin Ellis, minister of the gospel and former president of the Daniel Christian Center. Let us pray. God of grace and God of glory, we thank you for this glorious season of the year in which neither war, nor flood, nor earthquake, nor hurricane can drown out the sound of the angels. We hear that angels say, there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior who is Christ the Lord. O God, prepare us in the days ahead to receive the Christ child. Open the windows of our soul to the fresh air of thy Spirit. Blow out the stale air of this materialistic, self-centered culture. Forgive us our sins, those we hate and those we love too much. Create in us a clean heart that is appropriate to receive Jesus. Now we look forward to the celebration of Christmas. You and our forebears have made it beautiful. We thank you for music and children, for their sweet voices and happy faces. We thank you for flowers and lights, for rich friendships made richer, for love and goodwill. But chiefly we thank you for Jesus, the Creator become the created. He emptied himself of his heavenly glory and became one of us. The world had long awaited his arrival as a conqueror of enemies, crushing them to their knees. And you surprised the world by walking down the stairs of heaven with a baby in your arms. May this babe of Bethlehem come to our troubled world. May the Christ of history, whom we worship, be to us the Christ of today. Make every town a Bethlehem, every home a stable, every heart a manger. In the name of Jesus, amen. And now, peace.